Preference shares. The term preference shares is mentioned in Section 43 of Companies Act 2013. Usually, preference shares are issued to selected set of investors only. Now, why did the preference share get its name? The preference shares, they have either a preferential right to the payment of dividend or the preferential repayment of capital. So that is why they got the name preference shares. The first one, preferential right to payment of dividend. So the investors who are having, who are in possession of these preference shares, will either get a fixed amount of dividend or fixed rate of dividend, that is calculated as a percentage on the face value. So either it is a fixed amount or it is a fixed rate calculated on the face value. So that is the preferential right to payment of dividend. The second one, it is about repayment of capital. On the event of the liquidation of the company, the preference shareholders are paid a fixed premium over and above the face value of the company, or they are paid a premium on a fixed scale. The fixed scale could be again a percentage on the face value. It could be 100%, 200% or any number on calculated on the face value. So this is about repayment of capital in terms of preference shares. So those preference shareholders will be given special treatment in case of dividend or in case of repayment of capital. Preference shares. So in this slide we are going to see about the types of different preference shares. The first one is cumulative preference shares. Cumulative means the dividends gets added up and it is paid in the subsequent years. Non-cumulative means the dividends on the preference shares do not get accumulated. If the company makes a loss in a few years, then for those years dividend will not be declared and the dividends will not accumulate also. The third one, convertible preference shares. Convertible means the preference shares can be converted into equities, normal equity shares, at the end of the specified period. The fourth one, redeemable preference shares. Redeemable means the preference shares can be redeemed after a specified duration. For example, say 5 years or 10 years. The Companies Act says that no preference shares can be issued as irredeemable preference shares. So in that sense, all the preference shares are redeemable. 5. Participating preference share. Normally, the preference shares holders will get a fixed rate or a fixed percentage of dividend throughout the duration of the preference share. Suppose if the company makes a huge profit, then the participating preference shareholders might get a share on that excess profit also. I mean, the excess profit over and above the already paid dividend to equity and preference shareholders. So the company will make a standard payment of, a fixed rate of payment to the preference shareholders and the equity shareholders. And even after that, the company has a lot of cash left. So the participating preference shareholders will get a share on that excess profit also. Non-participating preference shares is exactly the opposite of that. So these preference shareholders, non-participating preference shareholders, will not get any share on the excess profit of the company. The seventh one, fully convertible cumulative preference share. So as the name indicates, the entire amount of these fully convertible cumulative preference shares will be convertible to equity shares. So it consists of two parts, part A and part B. Part A is automatically converted to equity, and the part B of fully convertible cumulative preference share will be optionally convertible to equities. So these are all the different types of preference shares.